And I think it's wonderful to be able to kind of establish those new stressors in our lives, but then also depict these women like taking the time to take a deep breath, get the help that they need, lean on each other in ways that, you know, we were more embarrassed to do back in the 90s.
I love this show. I cannot wait for everyone to see it. It's been such a breath of fresh air this week, getting to screen at least the first half of season one. And I wanted to know for you, of course, you can't help but watch this and think about some other beloved characters that you've created for us, especially when Erica Alexander is there to remind us of her time as Max and living single. So I wondered, I mean, what has changed between then and now, writing a group of, you know, hungry, cool Black women friend group between living single and Run the World? How have we evolved?
Well, we continue to evolve, you know, and I think at the foundation, the DNA is very similar. You know what I'm saying? We've always been fierce. We have always clung to our girlfriends in tribal ways. It's like, so those things are the same, but the world has changed. The world is a much more complex world now. You know, people have more access to us. We have more things grabbing at our attention. It's a faster paced world. And I think that we kind of captured the tempo of that and the pressure of that in this show. And I think it's wonderful to be able to kind of establish those new stressors in our lives, but then also depict these women like taking the time to take a deep breath, get the help that they need, lean on each other in ways that, you know, we were more embarrassed to do back in the 90s. You know, to see those women in therapy, like, it ain't nothing but a thing, it's just something I need, hashtag self-care, is really wonderful. You know, it's been a fun journey for me to be able to kind of be able to depict the evolution of our journey as African-Americans and our relationship to healthcare, you know, to going from, you know, Whitley Gilbert on A Different World, who was, you know, like too ashamed to get, you know, healthcare. Yeah. And then, to having then Jasmine Guy play Khadijah, Queen Latifah's therapist on Living Single, and she was too embarrassed to get, you know, to get help. You know, she went in there with a wig on, and that was like ridiculous to have these women just like, okay, Dr. Nancy, tell me what I need to be doing, because I got some stuff to unload. And just like, it just is, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not really like we were leaning into topics. We were just leaning into our realities and what our needs are, and not being afraid to articulate, like, I want more. I want more than what this relationship is offering. I want more than what this job is getting me right now. You know, to just say, this is who I am, unabashedly, unfiltered, and in this lush, lavish backdrop that is Harlem. I mean, like, I so love the treatment that we were able to give Harlem, the hug that we were able to give Harlem with this show, to really see it for the very rich, culturally rich and lush place that it is. I mean, it's just, we often see it depicted in this very gritty way, but to be able to kind of get into those Harlem streets and put a more beautiful light on it was a gift for sure.